right now. Close your eyes and take a deep breath. And exhale. Just want to invite you to forget where you are for a second and just invite a spirit and a heart of worship this morning. Want to invite the Holy Spirit to come in here, to come in this atmosphere and bless our hearts and be in this time of worship. Yeah.
Thank you. out there that are going to fulfill us and that are going to sustain us. But in reality, they're not. The only kind of love that's really going to fulfill us and sustain us, make us want to wake up in the morning, is the love that we're going to find in God. So I'm going to read you this verse from Isaiah 58, verse 9. It says, "Then you shall call, and the Lord will answer. You shall cry, and he will say, 'Here I am.' His love is reliable, it's unbreakable. He's never going to deny us."
I'm going to share Matthew 6, 33. It says, "But seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. All these things will be added to you." When I read that verse, I was like, oh, all these things. Like, that sounds nice, right? But the promise at the end of the verse is a reason that it says it will be added. It's because all those things in the world are never going to satisfy us the way God's love.
These verses are found from Romans 5, 6, 3. "For when the time was right, the Anointed One came and died to demonstrate his love for sinners who were entirely helpless, weak, and powerless to save themselves. Now who of us would dare to die for the sake of a wicked person? We can all understand if someone was willing to die for a truly noble person. But Christ proved God's passionate love for us by dying in our place while we were still lost and ungodly."
I'm going to go ahead and read 1 Corinthians 13:13, which says, "Three things last forever. That's faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of these is love." I love that verse because it talks about how if you don't have love, you don't have anything great. The Bible says the greatest of these is love. And God's love is greater, so much greater than you can ever dream or imagine or even understand.
1 Corinthians 13:7-8. "Love is a safe place of shelter, for it never stops believing the best for others. Love never takes failure as defeat, for it never gives up. Love never stops loving. It extends beyond the gift of prophecy, which will eventually fade away. It is more enduring than tongues, which will one day fall silent. Love remains long after words of knowledge are forgotten."
Guys, my name is Griffin, and I have the privilege of working with these guys all the time at Harborside, and I work with the high school students, and now the young adults pastor at Harborside, and we're about to sing this song called Reckless Love. Maybe you've heard it, it's a newer song. And I was thinking about, what does reckless love even mean? What does it mean that God loves you with a reckless love? John 15:13 says, "Greater love has no one than this, that he, Jesus, laid down his life for his friends." I was thinking about reckless love. Reckless love of God. Reckless love means that God loves you even if you don't return that love back to him. That he will love you with everything he has, enough to allow his one and only son, his perfect son, to die for your sins in your place, even if you don't respond back to him with love. That love is permanent, and it never changes, and it keeps on chasing after us. So reckless love means when you're running away from him, he still chases after you. Reckless love means even when you go into the darkness, his lights shine into that darkness because he wants you, and he wants to show you his love. And so as we get ready to sing that song, I just hope and pray that just for like 5 minutes, you realize it. And if anything, you get to experience through this worship and with all these people in this room singing this song, you experience the reckless love of God. Because when you do, it will change your life forever. God, it is amazing that you love us even though we don't always return the favor. Even when we're running after you as hard as we can, even when we're running away from you, God, even when we don't accept your love, we may be in the room and we're not even interested in worshiping you right now. Your love for us never changes. It's always the same. It's always perfect. And it's so reckless. God, may we just receive that right now. May every person in this place lift up their voice to you, proclaiming that we have a God who loves us so recklessly. In Jesus' name we pray.
Thank you.
pray that every day we get to worship you like that. And as we continue on with our day, I pray that we keep on worshiping.
Of your name, God, there is so much power in one word.
That is Jesus. I thank you so much for that. God, I pray that you would just have your hand over this presence that you have here, God. This body of believers just joined together to give you all the praise, God, to give you everything.